This is the 2012 NEC Men's Soccer Championship match as the four-seeded St. Francis Red Flash battle the two-seeded Fairleigh Dickinson Knights for the 2012 conference crown.
It's Jack McVay from the far side. He's going to put it on his left foot. Send it into the box. The header and a score! Just about 10 minutes into the final, the FDU Knights draw first blood.
Individual dribbling, trying to run their way through two and three players.
That's run up ahead, one on one. Once again, it's Doherty. Doherty trying to get it back, trying for the cross again. Valsacek knocks it down. Big time save with 10 minutes to play in the half. We'll get a key one here. Here's Kolarik sending it in, and it goes off the post and in.
It's Price.
Number six, James Price on the header, using all 6'4" of his body.
Here, who can make runs, he may make a nice run right here.
Here's Anthony Moore to the far side. The shot goes off the post. McVay charging on the left foot, trying to center it. The shot is blocked. Brenichea gets taken down. Trying to settle it down for the Knights. An opportunity here for St. Francis. Kolarik, the shot, and Lissek gets down to make the save.
10 seconds left.
They only need one. Here's McVay. McVay from the corner, going to the far post. The header gets deflected wide. Valsacek got a piece of it in the final 3 seconds. And the first 90 minutes of regulation soccer expire. Piece from the near corner. Up in the air, the only ones there waiting were white shirts. Back to Kolarik though, the cross right in front, and it goes off the post. Price again, and it goes over the crossbar. And it's saved! The FDU Knights are back on top for a record 7th time. Fairleigh Dickinson, your 2012 NEC Men's Soccer Champions.
The FDU Knights, your 2012 Northeast Conference Men's Soccer Champions. We're here with our Snyders of Hanover player of the game and the player of the tournament, FDU goalkeeper Jacob Lissek. Congratulations. What does winning the MVP of this tournament mean to you?
I've been putting in all the hard work throughout the whole year, and we wanted to come back to this championship game and finish it off right. We had a bad taste in our mouth after last year, and that taste is gone now.
Now, you had three saves in the two games of this tournament through the 110 minutes that you played in each game, but four stops in the two games combined in penalties. What's the mentality of a goalkeeper? What's your mentality when it's one-on-one, you versus the offensive player there in a penalty kick situation?
Just try to clear my head and just try to read the body of the player. And I was able to guess right a couple of times and made some big saves and helped my team win. So it's always a great feeling.
How about that final save? When you made that final save right there on the goal line, what was going through your head knowing that you just clinched it for your team?
I don't even know. Words can't even describe it. It was amazing. It was just an incredible experience.
And now the experience continues. You guys get to play on in the NCAA tournament. Northeast Conference teams have had great success representing the conference in the NEC. So what's the team's emotions now about going on and playing and representing the NEC in that next step?
Yeah, now we can celebrate for a little bit, but now we got to get back to work and hopefully do some damage in the NCAA tournament. Looking forward to that.
Well, Jacob, congratulations to you on the MVP and the rest of your team on the championship.
Thank you.
Jacob Lissek, our 2012 NEC Tournament Most Valuable Player and the Snyders of Hanover Player of the Game and the Tournament here in 2012. Right now, let's send it over to my broadcast partner, Ryan Horn, who's standing by with the head coach of the FDU Knights in Seth Rowland. Ryan?
And I'm with Coach Seth Rowland, who has booked the trip to the NCAA Tournament once again. Coach, with all you've overcome, how does it feel to get back to the NCAA Tournament for the first time since 2008?
Well, these guys have been committed and dedicated since 365 days ago to get to this point, to where we were playing in the championship game again, and this time to have a different result and to win the NEC championship. These guys deserve all the credit in the world. They've worked their tails off for the past year, and they've done a great job doing what needed to be done to this year, taking home the NEC championship.
Now, winning penalties on penalties twice in both your matchups, what kind of mentality does that take for your players, and what kind of mentality have you built into these players that they could come up in these pressure situations and win on penalties, not once, but twice in this tournament?
Well, we try to project confidence, and the guys believe in themselves, and we try to validate that and instill that in them. And these guys are confident, and they like the pressure situation, and they have a great mentality, and that's what's allowed them to rise to the occasion and be victorious.
And what can you say about your MVP goalkeeper, Jacob Lissek, coming up two big saves in this penalty shootout?
Well, Jacob was on a little bit of a mission too. We feel he's the best goalkeeper in the conference, and he wasn't acknowledged on first or second team with the awards. And I said to Jacob, Jacob, just help lead us to the championship and become the MVP. Little did I know that it'd be so prophetic. But it's great for him. I'm really happy for Jacob. And I'd also like to say, St. Francis has one of the top young coaches in Division I in the country. Michael Casper is not just a great coach, but he's a great person, a person of high integrity. And the job he does with them, with his players, is remarkable. I mean, he's a young guy. He's a kid. And he's so mature. He's so polished. And, I have great admiration for him. And I think the NEC and Quinnipiac University, in the midst of a 12-day weather crisis, did a tremendous job allowing the student athletes to have a championship. And they made it happen. And I think they did a great job, and they deserve a lot of credit.
We agree with all of that, Coach. And very classy from Coach Roland, giving credit to his opposite counterpart, Coach Casper. Coach, congratulations. Good luck in the NCAA tournament.
Thanks a lot. I appreciate it.